Hello and welcome back to Scale Me Down. I'm here today with our friend Dave for some behind the scenes product development. Remember to like and subscribe to support the channel. We're revisiting the Webbit, which is an ideal model for club flying and also for fun flies, and makes a great canvas for air modelers to carry out their own fun modifications. So this Webbit 3.0 will be a laser cut kit to make it easier and more accurate to build, and also to include provision for electric or IC power. Dave and I were invited by Steve Webb Models to build and fly a pre-production kit to give our insight and make any changes in case the kit goes into production. This should be great to gauge how much interest there is in the project, and we'd love to hear from you in the comment section below. Let's compare this up-to-date version with the original model. The pink one is Dave's model. It's around 15 years old and it's powered by an Enya 15. The wings are held on by elastic bands and are symmetrical in section. I put my 3.0 together for electric power, employing a 2814-8 motor along with a 40 amp speed controller to turn a 10x6 prop from a 2200 mAh 3-cell battery pack, and I get about 10 minutes of flight time from this setup. Another club member, Darren, joined us and he couldn't wait to have a go on the sticks.
So we've had a great fun day here this afternoon. Darren, what do you think of these little models?
Well, as you know, I hadn't flown one of these before, and I have to say I'm a convert for a 15 size Glow model. Fully aerobatic, easy to build. I'm going to build one.
The refreshed 3.0 design uses a Clark Y section for the wings, which is easier to build, yet it's still sprightly and aerobatic. It's a lightweight yet robust design, an ideal winter hack.
Dave, you're partway through the build. What have you done that's different from the original parts?
So far I've made the wing from the plan, but I've used the wraparound system that's on it. I think it would be better built like yours, which is the standard way of putting a leading edge on.
Other than that, how do you find the fit and finish of the parts to date?
Excellent. Everything fits exactly without having to sand down or anything. It's been really good to build.
I hope you've enjoyed this look behind the scenes into Steve Webb Models' top secret skunk works. If this kit were to go into production, how would you build or modify it? Please leave your comments in the section below. Thanks for watching.